This morning we learned already a lot about what's going on in Europe, and as I already said, I really want to know if we should also be that far, because we are just started with our implementation of our research of micropollutant removal. This is a picture of the Netherlands. The red spot is Amersfoort, the center of the Netherlands, in which STOA is located. And STOA is working for the 21 water authorities in the Netherlands. And we want to address the national topics for the Dutch water authorities. And our working area relates to the urban water management, flood prevention, wastewater treatment, and waste system management. And I'm a research manager, and I work on the wastewater treatment system, a wastewater engineer. And at the moment, the removal of micropollutants is a major topic, but also the nutrient and resource recovery on wastewater treatment plants is a hot topic. The topic of micropollutants started a few years ago, and it was launched by the several reports, studies on the impact of micropollutants. And the National Institute for Public Health and Environment, a very recommended institute in the Netherlands, they did research on the amount of pharmaceutical residues which are emitted to the surface water in the Netherlands, and they calculated that it should be 140 tons each year of pharmaceutical residues. Well, that's an impressive number. And they also looked at the effects in surface water, the tissue damage and also the endocrine disrupting effects on biota and the behavioral impacts. And if you look at the routing of pharmaceuticals, then most of us need pharmaceuticals, and we excrete them via normal use to the toilet, and a small part, only 5%, is discharged directly in the toilet bin or in the toilet and in the toilet. So the normal routing is just via excretion by urine and feces. The idea is that a large part is also emitted from hospitals and care centers, but the main part is just emitted at home, because people take their medicines at home and they go over there to the toilet. That brings up that there is for the national government, they prepared an approach for the whole chain, the water chain, in which there is attention to or projects which look at the development and authorization of pharmaceuticals, and also for the doctors in the hospitals and pharmaceutical companies to look at the prescription and the use of medicines, and also the wastewater and sewage treatment. Well, that's the topic in which we are now today, we look at, and the sewage system and the overflows are an important part of the following strategy which we are using. We look at the end of pipe measures, and the national government is stimulating implementing existing technologies in the Netherlands. And existing technologies, then we look at Switzerland, Germany, what they are doing, and well, it is more or less proven technology for the Dutch situation. But besides that, we have the national government also contributes to an innovation program, which we are performing together, and additional supportive projects. But before you take your measures at a wastewater treatment plant, it is good to know to investigate the impact of sewage treatment on the surface water. In the Netherlands, we have about 314 sewage of treatment plants, and in 2017 we performed a hotspot analysis to analyze the impact of pharmaceuticals, micropollutants on surface water. And we calculated the impact on the surface water in different ways. For instance, what is the effect of a specific discharge to influence drinking water intake, but also the effect of the discharge and the increase of the concentration locally at the surface water. With this study, we and this way of thinking, we selected about 100 sewage treatment plants that could need improvement. In the Netherlands, the water authorities decide themselves if they want to install advanced treatment, and this national study just focused attention to those wastewater treatment plants, and the water authorities have to see for themselves to do the research, the calculations again, if they are really need the advanced treatment at that locations. But the whole concept of that there is more need for improvement of wastewater treatment, and was also recognized by the national government, and they have granted a subsidy for 16 million euros for stimulating the full-scale implementation of advanced treatment at wastewater treatment plants. And they launched a subsidy program in which they used the 7 cents per cubic meter. And this morning we heard 7 cents 7 cents earlier, based on the our own pilots, but also on the experiences on Germany and Switzerland, that during a certain time they. That the amount of subsidy is related to 7 cents per cubic meter. We also want to, when the installations are installed, that they should be in practice for at least 10 years. It's needed for the to where you implement such an installation. And biological effect monitoring is a very important issue, that all the installed advanced treatment should have their biological effects. And of course, we also have a list of 11 guide substances. I think they are a little bit different than the lists we saw this morning, but it has the same idea. You have a list of 7 and you have to remove at least 70% of 7 of those 11 compounds. This gives enormous attention and for the water authorities to think about which places, what techniques are going to be used in the next future. And if we look at what we have been doing to prepare the water authorities to take the right decisions, that, first of all, we looked what neighboring countries did on this topic. So in 2015, we already visited Switzerland and Germany to see the experiences with advanced treatment. It gave us also the opportunity to make a technology overview on all the techniques which were used for advanced treatment. And in 2018, we did experiments on a full-scale plant with powder-activated carbon. And it was a very good study because we had a nice reference street, one plant with two flow lanes, treatment lanes, one with powder activated carbon and one without. At another wastewater treatment plant, we did some experiments with ozone dosing and also the effects on on advanced treatment. And those techniques are now more or less the standard techniques, which we think they can easily be applied in the Netherlands. But besides that, as I already mentioned, that is that we also have an innovation program because we think the standard techniques can be used, but sometimes they can also be better used or they can be improved. It is an innovation program for during 5 years, and it's hosted by STOA, and it is funded by the Dutch Water Authorities and the Ministry of Infrastructure in the Netherlands, and also STOA. And the focus of that program is that we want to research treatment systems to make them ready to be rebuilt in practice, to be applied in practice, and the treatment technologies on the threshold of breaking through. Just we need to have more confidence of rebuilding them on full scale, and it can also be optimizing of existing technologies. And the new techniques we are going to investigate should have an added value compared with existing techniques. And then we compare them with activated carbon, granular activated carbon, powder activated carbon, or ozone applications. So they should have a higher removal rate, or they should have lower costs, or they should score better on the sustainability score, or the eco-toxicological risk should be lower. That is a very major program for the coming years for us. 11.7 million euros to spend on research. That's for the amount of money we spent on research, quite impressive. And besides that, we have also a fundamental research program, which we do together with KWR for 4 years. But the overall goal of the innovation program is to, when you look at technology readiness levels, to go at least to a technology readiness level of about 7, about here, that you can implement them on full scale. And we do that by performing feasibility studies, tests on laboratory scale, and also piloting new technologies. And as I said, well, we compare them to existing technologies. For instance, the PACAS, the powder activated carbon, the ozone with sand filtration, and the granular activated carbon. And we look at the CO2 footprint of the application, and the costs, 7 cents, or when you have a higher removal rate, the cost can also be higher. For instance, if you see that the powder activated carbon is the technique in which the costs are not that high, but also the removal rates are not that high in relation to the other techniques. But it gives a good framework to compare new technologies with the existing technologies. And they are all, the costs are per treated cubic meter wastewater, because in the Netherlands we have also a high ratio rainwater, dry weather flow, and sometimes we don't treat the whole water flow for the advanced treatment. Well, the innovation program 2019, last year we made an inventorization of all the research opportunities, and there were a lot of ideas to see if advanced wastewater treatment can be better. And this gives an overview of all the projects we are now performing on this topic. And that's only the first launch of the program. We have several projects on the granular carbon application, the adsorption. We have four projects, and the powder activated carbon. The oxidation is also an important one, and the filtration pilots. The filtration pilots, they are more related also to the water factories, to the reuse of water. They are they deliver high quality water, and they also remove the micropollutants. One of the projects I want to highlight is we look at the application of powder activated carbon, but also if there are alternatives to for powder activated carbon and with a lower ecological impact or sustainability impact, because the production of activated carbon has a high CO2 footprint. And if there are other resources to make effective activated carbon, it can lower your ecological footprint. That is a very nice program. From all these techniques, we are now performing feasibility studies. And if they succeed on the feasibility, then we are going to perform pilot studies. And pilots, that means application on a wastewater treatment plant on small scale before we are going to apply them on full scale. We are now in 2019 assessing the feasibility studies, and the pilots are foreseen for the next years, or a few of them, in which of the, all the 20 projects. And next year we are also going to see if there are new technologies or ideas of research for the coming year. So we will be very busy till at least 2023 performing all kinds of feasibility and pilot studies to see if we can make advanced wastewater treatment better, cheaper, or better. As I mentioned, we also have a collaboration with KWR. A few years ago, we did a call for scientific proposals, and it led to the CEC program, the Contaminants of Emergent Concern, with NWO, our scientific partner. And we have five projects running on this topic, and in relation to the treatment systems, then the ADOX project is a very interesting project related to performed by the TU Delft, and it looks at the application of zeolites in as a treatment system, and also the SERCEC project looks at the treatment at regular wastewater treatment plants, how it is, what the scientific principles are between the differences of removal rates between different wastewater treatment plants, the regular activated sludge plants. In order to learn from that, and also to perhaps also to upgrade it for and improve removal in activated sludge. This is a scientific program, thus it will take at least 4 to 5 years in which results can be presented, final results. Now, besides the innovation program, the scientific program, we have also some supportive projects. We are harmonizing the analyzing methods between all the laboratories, including the sampling of the samples, because it takes a lot of money to for the sampling. And it's good to harmonize the activities between all the laboratories. Biological effect monitoring also, especially on effluents, has attention to improve that methods. And well, we also like to share our knowledge with our neighboring countries on this topic. The rainwater and the dry water flow is also an important issue for building and constructing and calculate how large the installations must be, and also we are also involved in developing a tool for the hydraulic capacity. Well, knowledge exchange in the Netherlands, we like to discuss and exchange our knowledge intensively. We have also a community of practice within the organizations who are dealing with advanced treatment. So we can cooperate and enhance our decision making and monitoring of advanced treatment. My conclusions is that we are ready to beat the micropollutants. We can learn a lot from other countries, and we are also ready to implement micropollutant removal at full scale. But because of all the activities on research programs, there is still a very high boost on innovative technologies. There are still a lot to develop on this topic, because it's quite new for us, the whole topic, and we need to learn a lot about how it works in practice. But after all, we are ready to see what micropollutant removal can be, how it can be implemented in the Netherlands. That was my speech.